I am here with sad news this morning, that with sorrow we inform you that the Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI passed away today at 9:34 in the Mater Ecclesiae Monastery in the Vatican.
That was Matteo Bruni, director of the Holy See Press Office. He uttered those solemn words on Saturday, January 31st, 2022.
On Wednesday of the 28th, in the afternoon, he had received the anointing of the sick in the monastery at the end of the Holy Mass. The body of the Pope Emeritus will be in the Basilica of St. Peter's, where the faithful can go with their prayers to greet him and to say goodbye.
Nearly 10 years have passed since the late Pope Emeritus Benedict XVI resigned the papacy. In that decade, he spent his time largely in silence within the Vatican's walls, sustaining his successor, Pope Francis, and the entire Church with his prayer. As we mourn his passing this week on Vatican Viewpoint, we also recall his almost 8 years on the See of Peter as Bishop of Rome. With the help of Cardinal Schönborn and Sean Patrick Lovett, Veronica Scarisbrick looks back over the papacy of the man born in Germany on April 16, 1927, as Joseph Ratzinger.
It was the afternoon of the 19th of April 2005 when white smoke billowed out of the Sistine Chapel chimney to announce the election of a new pope. Moments later, the bells of St. Peter's pealed loudly in celebration, and the people of Rome heard and flocked to the square in great numbers, only just in time to hear the customary announcement, "We have a new pope," in Latin.
Habemus papam, eminentissimum ac reverendissimum dominum.
When they heard the name Joseph,
Josephum,
and then Ratzinger,
Cardinalem Ratzinger,
they cheered. They immediately recognized a prominent and familiar figure in the Catholic Church. After all, he'd been one of the late John Paul II's closest advisers for over two decades. And when the new successor of Peter appeared at the central balcony of the Basilica in his white cassock, following in the footsteps of his predecessor, who'd broken new ground in this respect, he addressed the crowds.
Dopo il grande Papa Giovanni Paolo II.
Dear brothers and sisters, after the great Pope John Paul II, the cardinals have elected me, a simple, humble worker in the Lord's vineyard.
Signori cardinali hanno eletto me, un semplice, umile lavoratore nella vigna del Signore.
But the real surprise came when the Pope announced he would take the name Benedict. The last successor of Peter to take that name had been elected in 1914 as Austrian Cardinal Christoph Schönborn, one of the cardinals to elect the new pope, explains.
It is evidently a signal. He has explained it himself. It's Benedict XV, Pope of Peace in a time of war. So peace is the message of this name. And Saint Benedict, the father of the monks, patron of Europe, the man who said that we have to direct all things in our life to Christ. So I think this name says he is a blessing, a Benedictus.
Who exactly was this German pope? Well, he was born in a small town of Upper Bavaria on the Austrian border on the 16th of April 1927. His university years had been taken up with philosophical and theological studies from 1946 to 1951, and ended with a doctoral dissertation centered around the notion of the people of God in St. Augustine, and a postdoctoral work on St. Bonaventure, a Franciscan theologian from the 13th century. Qualifications that led to a teaching position at the University of Bonn. That's until he was called to Rome in 1962 to attend the Second Vatican Council as an expert. When the council ended in 1965, he went back to Germany once again to teach, this time round at the University of Tübingen. Then in 1977, Pope Paul VI appointed him Archbishop of Munich. That's until 1981, when Pope John Paul II appointed him as prefect of the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith, a position he held for over two decades, until his election to the papacy. It was during these latter years as prefect of this congregation that he became a familiar figure in Vatican circles, in a special way here at our radio station, where he crossed our threshold many times, joining us in our studios, first as cardinal, affording us a self-portrait, saying,
È un po' impossibile, un autoritratto è sempre un problema difficile, soprattutto giudicare se stesso è impossibile, direi.
All I can say is that I come from a very simple, very humble family, and I don't really feel like a cardinal. I feel I'm just a man. In Germany, I lived in a small town, and there I feel at home.
And then later as Pope, when less than a year into his pontificate, he was back at our radio station once again. It was the 3rd of March, 2006, and this time his words were of encouragement.
Today, the voice of Vatican Radio can reach every part of the world to help build this great family that knows no frontiers, in which all are brothers and sisters, in the multiplicity of cultures and languages, and thus constitute a peacemaking force.
Certainly, if one had to identify the legacy of Benedict XVI, his extraordinary ability with words, both in print and in the spoken form, would come to mind, starting from his homily during Holy Mass to mark the beginning of his Petrine ministry on the 24th of April 2005.
Master must be inspired by Christ's holy zeal. For him it is not a matter of indifference that so many people are living in the desert. And there are so many kinds of desert. There's the desert of poverty, the desert of hunger and thirst, the desert of abandonment, of loneliness, of destroyed love. There's the desert of God's darkness, the emptiness of souls no longer aware of their dignity or the goal of human life. The Church as a whole and all her pastors, like Christ, must set out to lead people out of the desert.
Then, beyond his moving homilies, there were his addresses during the weekly general audiences and the many speeches he delivered on journeys in the public square, among them those in English in the United States, Australia, and the United Kingdom. And in the written word, there were many documents and three encyclicals, Deus Caritas Est, God is Love, in 2005, Spe Salvi, Saved in Hope, in 2007, Caritas in Veritate, Charity in Truth, in 2009, and also publications. To quote but one, the well-known Jesus of Nazareth trilogy. But this gentle, scholarly Pope also had his share of battles during the eight-year pontificate. He had to deal with scandals both from within the Vatican, with the leaking of documents, and from without, with the clerical sexual abuse issue, scandals to which he responded, becoming a promoter of justice and child protection. However, the gesture that most astonished the world was Benedict XVI's resignation. It took place on the 28th of February 2013 and left the world in shock. No Roman pontiff had done this for almost six centuries. Since that day, he became known as Benedict XVI, Pope Emeritus, and in the twilight years of his life retired within Vatican walls, continuing to write and leading a quiet life of prayer and meditation.
Thank you for joining us here on Vatican Viewpoint. We'll be back again next week.